initially a lot of fighting. We've been hoping for it, but let's listen to the players first. Over the lineups here, we're going to start with the Dashing Buffalo, best known as the Fung Fu Buffalo. Before now, they just got more dashing. One of the reasons for that is their change in top laner. Zeros is out, Reizo is in. The rest of the names, you back to Imp, to the Korean side. Last time I saw him in Korea was the 2015 Summer Finals in as a guest. It was him and Ryu talking, reminiscing about old days. Imp certainly has been up and down. It's LGD time at the start. Damage, but they're gonna go Zoe anyway. Now, on the one hand, this is comfort. On the other hand, it's gonna be base damage. It's gonna be basically the Zoe kind of starting the show, and any skirmish with her has crowd control for her to follow up on. And then outside the poke face, Imp is gonna be a really big, hard carry on this side. But if you look, well, he's trying to turn that shoe around. It's mid lane, vintage Yagao.
Yeah, that is a chunk of damage onto Gnoll, which he's not gonna be able to get back too easily.
Against his opponent when it comes to a mount against bot side engage starts.
Okay, this is a 2v2 for now, but Meliodas is coming in with Predator ready to body bomb in. Imp level 6, but Lumao at 5 sacrifices himself. First blood over to the VCS.
Even though it's not level 6, the mind game is there.
They should have a much better lane. Flawless will actually find Palo. Does get Shadow Dash, the explosive cast comes out. Flawless in trouble as the bubble comes through, but I think Flawless left alone. He can't flag and drag away. The flash is over. Gnoll has the perfect execution, finds his way over, and JDG lose yet another with Yagao unable to get a response.
The moment the sweeper found Palo, actually there was no exit plan available for Flawless, trying to pop solve himself out with an EQ. Didn't want to flash late. Sion, and to me, Sion is very much about hitting the ground running. This is going to be a lot of damage.
To get it in the end, and that was a short trouble bubble for that much.
But the trouble is clearly there with Flat Pen already done.
Right.
We talked about those killer instinct ganks on the first back. A super tank in the top side. When does the ult come in?
Gonna get it at melee range, pops it now into the world, and it comes in immediately with that killer instinct as you talk. The Shen Stan United, is it in time? Yes, it is. Palette's up here, but the decimating smash takes him out. Palette just watches him die in the end.
And the flash, very optimistic when they had no idea that there was only enemies in the mid.
They push them off of it, but will JDG keep contesting?
Do have perfect execution available, so Kali can be annoying here.
Oh, but then suddenly the fight's over because Yagao comes in on the side.
Suddenly Zoe, we're rolling back the clock. It's spring again for JDG and for their
drop down. And for Dashing Buffalo, they're going to commit 4 members to the top side in stopping this, but better team fight right now.
The ward here is doing so much work.
You're going to see the world ender. You're going to see an Aatrox die before it can open up. Teleport to come in, and Zoom has the ulti available if he wants to set up for a second fight.
And that ward was super high value for JDG. They want to get that first turret. Let's break it here.
Now Zoom can take this up, minion wave or not. JDG open up the map and get the first big gold lead of the game.
Understand the teams want to take it easy, and especially for a team like JDG,
more control. Okay. League of Legends Flawless has been caught out, so there's no control there. He flashes, he survives for now. Palette to go gold, but Imp is doing a great position. Teleport through as well from Norm, who joined the fight into the backline. Imp's been caught out. The killer entering in the backline, though, survives for long enough to take down one. Yagao from the side as well. The other damage threat is Norm. Can't re-engage. He's used his burst potential. Now the Aatrox needs a reset. It's onto Lumao. He wants to get the World Ender pumping nice and early. Does find the one kill. And now for the reset, as Yagao takes him down. A messy fight we're now finally getting. Flawless with the Cataclysm. Better late than never. Reizo to jump in, but his ult's expended. Yagao has been leading this fight, and Doom's right along with him. The Dumpling Brothers reunite at Rift Rivals.
Ask and ye shall receive. Finally, the fight comes out. One initiated by Dashing Buffaloes, where they just weren't all in position. Reizo was by far the last person there, and JDG able to take them down in the end. Watch the play happen here. As it all started, and it looked like it was going to be pretty innocuous, right? Just looking for a pick, and that would be enough. The initiation comes in, Flawless doesn't die, and that's where things get awkward with how the fight is going. Aatrox decides to take a full back into a TP as the action kind of starts.
Yeah.
So as the play goes on, it's pretty even as things are going, but 5v4 is always going to hurt, and I feel like we shouldn't be surprised that Dashing Buffalo traded down, because when they re-engaged, it was two pretty healthy people for Ryzen to come in after a lot of cooldowns were down.
Also, the bane of their existence in the end is that Flawless survived for so long, came in for this final Cataclysm, which
frankly, turn that bite into your Gallen Zooms trophy.
Yeah, it could have been 5v4 on his thoughts in terms of how the fight was supposed to go, but
yep.
Smartly sticking around was able to still have a roll.
Very calm. I'm sorry, I cannot. Double Infernal on the menu now. DBL getting hit slowly. Zoom going to be the one who's face tanking this for now, but Lizo doesn't want to be here because we see the unstoppable onslaught once again falls into the backline. The troll bubble ends, it's Imp again who just gets free roam. And for JDG, they can go front to back as good as you like. Zoom does not die, and Big Coro has to stop attacking him because right now, for Dashing Buffalo, they need to get out of there. JDG heading forward. Rizo to go golden, but Nolan's backside with the perfect execution. Needs the perfect mark in the fight. The bubble lands again. Two-man decimating smash. It could be good for Dashing Buffalo, but Imp and Yagao still alive. They get the return kill, and Zombie Scion stops them for a moment, but ultimately, it's still a win for the VCS.
But we're liking it. We're liking it. We're seeing some skill checks on both sides a little bit later, but hopefully we can catch up. Pretty one-sided two games. Gotta feel like this would be up. Oh, hold the point, flawless.
We're finally fighting again though. Imp just killer instinct in. That's the Imp we know.
And that's the build he's playing. If you're gonna go Muramana, look for the picks. It's not as strong. And they extend to 5v5 until more items come in. So Imp is definitely wasting no time and swooping in at a moment's notice.
His killer instinct's down, but that's okay for now. Yeah, Zoom. Everyone saw it, and even right. Dashing Buffalo.
Cut that guy's portion of dumplings. He's getting a half portion of dumplings today.
Unfortunate.
Called mandu in Korean, in case you guys are wondering.
Okay. Zoom still has the ulti available, though, so he can redeem himself at Null. Caught out on
He's
the
on
flank.
He's on an adventure.
Yeah.
He's exploring the map.
NG know where he is, though, now. Imp doesn't have ult, so it doesn't matter if it lands. Blue Mouse coming up. Here's the depth charge. The Korean audience are just going, oh no, because Norl has to use the perfect execution. Ignites down, they lock him down. Dashing Buffaloes leave him. That's a pick for the turret as a trade.
Somehow, Zoom being caught with his pants down on camera actually caught out the enemy mid laner, which you'll take. They can start up Baron here, so Dashing Buffalo, they're trying to force a rotation. And JDG say, we're going to delete Baron, you better stop us.
And Pallet's there without the rest of the team. Yagao does magic damage, that means the Shen is going to regret this. Hit gets jumped on, flashes away, Culling's onto him as well. Look at Big Coro, the biggest of them. In fact, Dashing Buffalo, this could be their fight. Pallet saves his 80 carry, the biggest of Coro, still alive. Rizo going head first as well. And for Lumaus, to survive as long is good, but now they have to deal with a refed Aatrox. And Dashing Buffalo's walking away.
Oh.
They still want the kill, but Yagao. The LPL fight back.
They definitely do, but not necessarily the way you expect. It's kind of a how did we get here moment.
Okay, he caught out though. That's the death charge again. Sign ulti too. They just keep knocking up the Akali, who eventually survives. A lot burned for the mid laner as Zoom getting chucked in. The magic damage gets through him. Well, again, the Aatrox face forward while JDG relying on him. He finds the first kill, and now a numbers disadvantage as they run a one.
And it looked like maybe Ryzo could turn the fight, but specifically with cooldowns up, no one dies. Ryzo goes down, and I think it's a journey back to Baron, and it shouldn't be a surprise for Dashing Buffalo.
Yeah, using the stopwatch, imitating Zoom for a second as well. They're a cheeky duo, and for JDG, they've been playing a cheeky style here in this game, number one.
What do we got? We got a couple of control wards, all blue trinkets down. They don't have an idea about the health bar. Yagao is on the hunt. Remember, he can delete people.
And he has to be spotted now for Meliodas. He body bumps him, but he gets the trouble bubble, looking for the paddle star once again, while Norl wants to come in for the flank. He finds himself amongst one, but they're onto him. They just want this 80 carry to die, but Norl can't make it work. Yagao unchecked, comes into the side, lands the trouble bubble, and immediately back to the Baron.
Baron doesn't release. 5,000 health. Can they stop this?
Getting bursted down by Yagao even more so. Big Coro wants to run forward, but Baron secured there by JDG. Now to get out.
By hook or by crook, they get the Baron, and that's the big thing. Get the Baron, get out. You cannot try to feel this one out.
That's right, because Teleport's coming in from Zoom as well, who has ulti in hand. JDG with Baron up. Five members strong are just going to charge this one down.
They're being decisive, as they should, and Dashing Buffalo, they're looking for their moment. I don't know if they'll ever find one.
That trouble wobble lands. It could be preposterous as one does. It's onto the Aatrox. Hip jumps in with him as well, and JDG smack him in the butt as Dashing Buffalo left in a 5v4. That's going to be Palace ulti onto Norl, but honestly, someone else is going to die. He tries to escape. Imp won't let him. Neither will Lumao, who brings him all the way back into the frame. Dashing Buffalo back to the Nexus. Norl way too late as JDG pull the LPL Classic, bring the tempo into their first game, and look to set LPL up for a strong start at Rift Rivals.
Yagao skipping mad at the the end, we knew it would be a high-value ban. It's even faster than we could have predicted. You need a plan when Zoe and AP Kai'Sa get going, and it seems like JDG closed it out in the sort of fashion that the game didn't start with, but certainly earned.
Attention normally, and has not been playing as well as we'd like in the summer split.
And even if the LMS and BCS fans could kind of shrug off the first two games, Dashing Buffalo against a JDG team that only recently got going, it's a real gut punch to see them quite easily taken down in this matchup here. It does mean that they are very